Oh, Mr. Coates. I see this guy hanging around the lobby a lot, but not actually playing. So Hakumen's kind of hard to deal with, because he has a counter and not a normal DP, so I can't really get my heart offense started as cleanly as I normally would. But Hazama's whatever. I'm gonna go for the setup again. Looks like I don't need to. I definitely pressed 5D there. I guess it wasn't enough to hit that. Oh no, I saw the assist too late. This isn't gonna get much off this. Alright, I'll take it. I didn't really plan on it hitting that way, but it works. One more hit should be dead. Now he's probably gonna tech back, so I'm gonna throw out a fireball here. I was gonna do a nice fireball setup, but he kinda just jumped out. But this works too. Just punch him in the face. Sometimes the best way to win with heart, just punch him in the face. Get ready. But I know from that first match, the information round, that he doesn't really use the counter all that much. Oh no, it's getting intro. So I'm gonna be a little more aggressive with my offense. Look, there's a nice 11k combo here. Now he hasn't done the counter on wake up once yet. Whoops! I didn't really know what to do there. I was absolutely expecting a burst and I was only ready for a burst. I wasn't ready for the combo to just end. I didn't have a plan for the combo just ending. That was the mix up. Next up, he's fucking gonna call Hakumen. He didn't call Hakumen as OP. Ah, I 5B'd. It was too slow. That was my look kind of bad, but it's fine. Oh, that's plus on block. I guess even if you block that overhead, it's plus on block. Try to 4A out of that. It might have been hitboxes too, because there's a 4A that kind of hits high. There's a 2A that's slow. Maybe it was just a matter of hitboxes rather than frame data there. Anyway, doing jump forward homing, not neutral jump forward homing, but just jump forward, hold forward, up forward homing, is really good. You get a nice natural cross up. If they jump out, you get to follow them out with that jumpy. You get to keep them on the ground. You can dash up to them and do that. It works as a throw bait, and you'll kind of circle back around and get a punish on the throw away. It's really nice. Now I could have homing canceled that, but then I didn't. Yeah, that takes reactions that I do not have at this time of day. Or night. Now you see me doing these DP combos here. That's just to prevent him from... prevent him from bursting. If I see their burst stage is about to come back, or I know they're gonna burst, I usually just see that. It's pretty close. I don't know if he's dead. Yeah, he's dead. Oh, he's not dead. Now I'm gonna go for a DP bait here. Yeah, he's pretty good. He's pretty good about not DPing or countering with Hakuman. Even though with the way I use assist Oki, there's really no reason for him not to. Because if you counter an assist with Hakuman, I think it's just safe. Also, I had an execution at the character select there. Execution error at the character select. Oh no, it didn't do the third hit. He wasn't ready for that either, it looks like. So I'm just gonna block here. Nice. Got the anti air. Ooh, nice throw. Yeah, that was smart. He saw me whiffing the throw, so he knows throw is on my mind, but it whiffed. Ooh. Alright, I can definitely make this comeback if I didn't get hit there. A bad game for me. Main execution error on the character select. Just that alone was not a good sign. But this connection's good enough where it doesn't matter that too much. Whoa. That's what he was trying to do there. Alright, what I'm gonna do here, instead of a cross up assist. You can set up cross up assist with that neutral homing jump, to homing hold up for, like I mentioned before, but they can jump out of it. You gotta condition them into doing that. I'm gonna be perfectly honest, I don't know what side it hits on half the time. Uh oh, wrong side. Wrong side. Wrong side. Let's get out of there. Alright, I wanna see something. I wanna try something here. I want him to cut one of Akatsuki's fireballs and then I parry the big orb that forms when he does that. I want him to cut this orb. Oh, I can't parry it. Alright, cut this orb. Cut the orb. Alright. This isn't what I'm trying to do, but it kind of works. Alright, I think I can parry that. I tried. I tried very hard to parry that. But we didn't really get to see what happened. So when you're playing online, sometimes you just don't wanna, you don't wanna play to win all the time. Sometimes you wanna experiment, lab stuff out online as you're playing. And that's what I try to do right there. I'm like, this is an interesting interaction. I wonder what happens if I try to parry it. Can't escape from crossing fate. Fight. Why am I backwards? Okay, that's sort of not really reliable, looks like. Whoops. I panicked. Try to go for the anti here. This might kill. He has his meaty air dashes in order here. Oh, it didn't burst! See, that's what I was talking about with the throw bait. With the jump forward homing. You dash at them, do that. You get a nice little punish there. They don't avoid a lot of DPs too, because you jump over them and behind them. So usually, upward moving DPs will just whiff. It depends though, but it's a good option to keep in mind. Now I'm gonna do punch or the Kazu. Wow, blue combos. Oh yeah, every time I do the DP combo, the trick to it is to hold forward. Hold forward after you do the double jump neutral homing. That's sick, okay. Whoops. I'm trying to hit with the 4A there, so I can get this jump move. Cause it's really easy on Hakumen and tall characters like this. Oh, that might be it. Sometimes you just get hit. I'm not sure where I got hit there. Sometimes you get hit. Alright, since I know that Hakumen can slash fireballs and you get that big orb on screen, I threw out the really slow love ball and then threw out a really fast laser so that he would get hit trying to slash the fireballs. And then the fireballs combo after. It's pretty good. Oh, they didn't combo? That's rare. Huh. Ooh, I got hit by the orb. Whoops, I did a big mistake. Huh. Not sure what that was about. I'm doing it. I'm gonna do it twice. It's okay, I don't need Akatsuki. Sometimes you're just put in a situation where like you gotta choose what character you want to play with the rest of the game. And I'm definitely choosing Hyatt over Akatsuki every single time. Although I might be dead here. Definitely dead there. Again, went for the combo, didn't get it, lost the game because of that. But it's fine. I don't mind losing. You're gonna lose a lot. It happens. But I went for the easy combo. I went for that 5A, 5B. I don't feel like doing a cross combo here because I don't think I'll get the meter, so I'm just gonna spend one bar and get AK. Ending super here, a good chunk of damage. Alright, rule number one of playing Heart, abuse backcombing as much as possible. Just like that. Also, I'm noticing here that Akatsuki 4P is really good against people up backing in the corner. Goes really high. It's at a nice angle to anti-air. Well, it was his DP, I better have a nice angle to anti-air. Alright, he's not used to playing height. I can tell because he's getting hit after these back homies. He's blocking high. Oh. I crossed myself up there. That was a misinput. If you ever see me do that in a block stream or something, that's just me trying to go into 2A and then missing. And then I get the fireball instead. It's pretty lame. Alright, I'm gonna hit him with 4 supers, is what I would say. I don't know why, but hitting with the super after that grab from the auto combo is really tough. I have problems with it. I tried. Sometimes you just gotta EX Tatsu. And that was not one of those times. But yeah, see? I'm getting that jump loop more consistently. I actually got the 5A afterwards. I don't think that's happened yet today. Wow. I'm doing it. It's bending the meter, why not? Oh, I messed that up. I messed that up too. I didn't mean to cancel that. I'm just mashing. I kinda had a feeling that he would go for a counter there. Didn't get the full rep, but you know what? It killed. We got the combo. See, getting better every time. Getting a little bit better every time. That's what we're aiming for here. That's what we need. That's what we want. I'm gonna do a punch at the round second. Wow, that hit really, really low. Or high. It hit differently than I would have expected. Huh. I keep going for these DP combos. I probably don't need to. Alright. Yeah, see, sometimes you just wanna do 236B on wake up. Oh, you see that A tattoo, the side twitch in the air? Because I knew it was going to jump up. Definitely on purpose and not just a lucky accident. Get ready. All joking aside though, doing random stuff like that and seeing it work out kind of gets your brain juices flowing. Like, I want to go into training mode after this. See if that's like a real setup that I can use. Oh, that's unfortunate. That's gonna hurt. I should have known that he was gonna do that. Like, he had no reason to do anything else there. Huh. Huh. That was weird. It's probably not what he wanted, but you know what? I'll take that. We take them. So I didn't really think about this before, but that jump AA, jump B, 4A jump loop is actually really good for happy birthdays. I guess the other one works well for happy birthdays too, but I think this has more corner carry and everything. And we'll just hit two characters at once better. Ah, I messed up. I pushed too many buttons. Okay, this works. Nice reset. It's like I'm really playing Skullgirls over here. This might kill. Let's see. Nah, not even close. I'll get a nice setup with heart. See, I don't think the normal version of the punch super gives you a safe jump, but the EX one will. If you hit it from high up, even more so, and Akatsuki launches at just the right height for that super to hit. Also, against Hakuma, nothing's really a safe jump, but you still get a nice setup off it, if nothing else. Whoops! Whoops, that was supposed to be, Oh, I jumped! I did neutral jump. And not forward jump. So he doesn't want to call assists. Do you want to call assist there for the health? Is a healthy recovery, I think. Anyway, I've never done this combo before. Is that plus? Oh no, alright, get out of there. Alright, so Akatsuki is super dead. Sama has no health though. I got a level 4 resonance. So you know I'm gonna go for the Astro. Oh, I flinched. He shot that chain in just the right time. Oops. That was a back home. Now Heart's Astral is 4 frame startup, which I think makes it one of the fastest moves in the game. So next time I get level 4 resonance, I think I'm just gonna sit on the 4 bars, let him come to me. Uh oh. Execution error on the character select. Let him come to me anyway. And mash out that Astral. Because that can punish a lot of things that are not usually punishable. Can't escape from crossing fate. So I'm gonna do B Tatsu round start. And this fate though. That was a really good use of cross combo. Did that just to get Heart in and Akatsuki out. Oh, big mistake. Who's gonna hurt? I'm just gonna keep Heart in. No reason not to keep Heart in here. Oh, that's a low. Nice anti-air fire seed. Ooh. I don't even know what move he used. We did something to bait that out. That was smart. Oh, he has a command grab. I forgot.
way. Right away. Let's see who's
sword. Oh, that's a lot of overheads. It's like 5 overheads. They all hit high. No super? Oh, that hit. Oh, that hit? A lot of stuff hitting that I don't expect to hit. Apparently the jump BB follow up from Hazama. It's a really good cross up hitbox. Who knew? I didn't. I tried anti-air 2B. Hit him with a trip guard. Actually, I don't know if trip guard even exists in this game, but usually if someone's jumping in the air, you hit him with a low right as they land. He's not gonna be ready for that. Well, sometimes. It depends. Depends on a lot of things. Can't escape from crossing fate. Anyway, I didn't have a missed input on the character select this time. Out of there. Nice confirm from me, never tried that before. Always gotta try new things in a game like this. Oh, he's very dead. Is what I would say. But he's clearly not. So if you do not use a double jump before you use homing, then you can double jump after you hit them with whatever button you hit them with after the homing. So what I did right there, right before I did the DP, I did a jump A, jump B, and then double jump forward to bait his DP, I guess. You can also double jump, call an assist after an air-to-air, which is really nice. Keep the pressure. Nice stare down. Nice, really fast stare down. Hey, he's finally doing it. He finally realizes that his offense is way too oppressive. I kind of have a feel for when he likes to push block now. So if you do have a read on when they push block. Oh. Wrong one. I meant to do the back one. I wanted to. Shit. Too fast. You can parry that, but. A little difficult. Actually, it's not that hard at all. You just gotta remember to do it later. Alright, remember when I said I was gonna go for the astral? Let me try to do that here. Damn, you really went for that. Well, I tried, but there was no opportunity for it. I'm gonna try it for the astral every single time I get a chance. As you can see, I build up level 4 resonance really fast. Because I'm always doing cross combo and calling assists and everything. So that builds it up really fast. No, no. Another missed input on the character select. Bad looks for me. Now I'm gonna do punch round start again, see what happens. Oh! Missed input on the round start. Oh, nice block. So you don't get anything guaranteed after you block or parry an assist with the Katsuki. I think you can scale here. The DAC. It can be a higher comeback with the Katsuki. Oh. I keep forgetting this character has a command grab. It's really, not something I would expect this character to have. Anyway, let me pick the right characters at character select this time. Get ready. Not that that's why I lost. But if you make a mistake before the match even starts, it kinda messes you up. Kind of get in your own head that way. I could have gone for an extended high combo, but I didn't. Alright, a lot of stuff happened there that did not plan to happen. Like that. Just like that. Out of there. Out of there. It's fine. Oh, it hit backwards. I have 4 bars again. I'm doing it. He didn't have a lot of health though, so. Oh. That was it. I dropped the combo again. That was the Astral. So when you have it in your head that you're trying to go for an Astral, or the pressure's up, like it's the last match, last round, grand final, something like that. It's a lot harder to execute simple stuff that you normally get. Whoops. Anytime you see me do like a laser, instant laser like that, usually not on purpose. That super sucks. I already gone for the super dose recently. Oh. I'm gonna go for the simple combo into super. I have no meter now. I do have resonance. It's only level 2 though. Wow. I hit cross up. Usually the way you bait anti-air is a tight. One of the main ways to bait anti-air is a tight at least. Is you do that neutral homing hold up forward technique that I talked about. That'll usually make you go all the way around them, cross them up. So if they go for an anti-air, usually the anti-air will go the wrong way. And you hit them from the other side. But not that time, I guess. Some anti-airs, like Susano, like Kazama, I guess, will hit on both sides. So you gotta watch out for those. This can also vary your speed at which you're homing at them to bait the anti-airs. You can homing downward. Oh, I messed it up. Yeah, you can tell I'm a little, little tired here. Dropping easy stuff like that. Oh, he didn't. Oof. Hmm. Interesting. I don't even know what's happening right now. Huh. That was a trade for the ages. He's good against those meaty chains, so I can't jump out like I've been doing. Oh, there we go. Missed input again. Some stuff happened there. Oh, you went for the low chain? Can I burst out of this? Better be able to. Oh, that's it. Alright. So in Arcana, and in this game too, you can cancel fireballs on whiff. And that's not a usual thing you can do outside of like YRC or FRC in Guilty Gear. So people that come from BlazBlue or Uni, I guess you can cancel stuff on whiff in Uni. People that come from BlazBlue probably aren't ready for that kind of stuff. Bad verse. Alright, so we can 2B on reaction. I think instead of jumping on wake up like I've been doing, it's better to do this on wake up. Cause that'll clash the chain like every time. It looks like. This isn't gonna be that much damage, so don't be worried. Oh, there's my 5B. Didn't come out. You know, during that cross combo, I probably should have switched to Hurt. This might be it? Nah. Whoops. That was back homing again, and I got the laser. Not sure why he did that. Oh man, it's 80 seconds, so I get meter for days. Alright, I'll take it. That was a weird round. I was trying to bait his push blocks. But he just kept respecting it afterwards, and it's like, I'm not sure why. I'm not plus after any of the punches, I think. Maybe against like Hilda, who doesn't have a fast enough button. But we should challenge those. I don't know why he's just sitting there and taking it. I'm gonna do the punch at round start. Akatsuki assist? Pretty good. It's a pretty good assist. Not sure why I get hit higher there. Good trade. Normally that would work. I try to parry that. Alright, I'm not gonna call Hurt. I don't think I'm dead, so it doesn't matter too much. I'm not gonna call Akatsuki at all. I gotta get this red health back, and there's a lot of it. Alright, it's not air unblockable. I wasn't sure if it was. It's about to be 80 seconds on the clock, so I'm about to give it lots of meters. Next hit wins. Oh no! Might as well try for it. He's at a pixel left and he can't recover any health, so... So I think I had the advantage there. It seems like Fireball in this cancel into Astro? Pretty safe, what do you know? Who would've thought? I'm gonna do the punch round start again. I hear he's gonna burst that every time. Ooh. Alright, I like when that happens. That is a safe jump. Even though that super is really fast, that safe jump is really fast as well. Whoops. Kinda messed up there. Oh, I take that. Alright. It works for me. Huh? 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 I'm keeping this two bars, it's not gonna kill. I need the active switch to get more health on heart. What happened there? I'm not gonna build another bar for super, this isn't gonna hurt too much. We saw you can go for overhead. Once I get the air to air, sure. Another thing I was experimenting with lately is how to convert from air to air hits with heart. You know, non-counter, because that's kind of something I have a problem with. So what you do is, in theory, you do jump A, jump B, and then if it hits, you do jump A, then jump B, and delay the last hit of jump B, just like the B and B. And theoretically, you should be able to get a 4A just like normal. Oh no, I got hit by the ant here. I don't know how to open people up with a Katsuki. I just kind of play this thing. Wow. A hit. I have to burst. I'm not gonna die from this, probably. Nah, I might die from this. Oh, he didn't go into cross combo. I might actually survive. Yeah. I was a push block, but it is too late. Try to anti here with 4A. Usually if you block Kazama's chain, it's kind of far away. You don't have to commit to a real anti-air button. A really slow, long anti-air button. You can usually just throw out a really quick, like 4A, it's kind of high up. And usually, most of the time, that's enough to deal with the follow-up attack. Huh. Do it again. Alright, so Akatsuki's counter really safe on this. I'll take this. That's not a big deal. I'm in the same exact position I was in before, except now he has no health. Also, it looks like his overhead goes pretty far. Oh, I did a 5B and it didn't hit. Oh no. I'm probably gonna tech back, so I'm gonna set up the fireballs again. Stay Oh yeah, I have 4 bars. I have level 4 resonance. But I'm not gonna make it. Alright, I guess I'm that way. Sure. I completely forgot I had level 4 resonance. I've been trying to go for the astral the entire time. Like, the one time I get a chance, I forget that I have it. Also, as far as, like, blocking heart air-to-air, half the time I don't know where I'm gonna end up. Although, most of the time I end up on the other side. Oh, I thought that would be safer than it was. Wow, that hit on that side? Alright. Oh, I almost got it. Unblockables. The last hit of Akatsuki is B. Tatsu hits high. Heart's 2A. Hits low. So you can imagine the rest. Unblockable. So you can get out of that though. Even though it's an unblockable, it's pretty easy to get out of. All you have to do is push block the second hit of Akatsuki's Tatsu. You get push blocked and then you can block the low. However, that's also a mix-up. Because if you push block the second hit of the Tatsu, you can get thrown out of that because you're push blocking an assist. And when you're push blocking, you are susceptible to throws, even though you're technically in block stun. So the mix-up is either push block and get thrown, or don't push block and get hit with the unblock. It's pretty nasty. Whoops. That one was pretty obvious. I kind of knew he was gonna do it. Anyway, big combo here. Gonna keep Heart on point, so there's no reason not to. Gonna bait him into doing that. Sometimes after a knockdown, you just want to do an empty homing. Huh, you threw me out of a 5A. And it worked. Also, there's no meter, and you activate resonance immediately. Not sure why. No super? And I'm gonna burst this, so you can bait it all he wants. Oh, he didn't go for that triple throw. The triple style throw. Now I've fought a Hazama or two in my time. Oh shit, not what I wanted. I'm not sure what I wanted there, but it wasn't a stand C. Wow, he blocked. This is an honest match, 1v1. Alright, that works. You know, sometimes the best anti-air is not your anti-air normal or your DP. It's just running back and forth underneath them while they're jumping and making them guess what side you're gonna land up on. Especially if they don't have a good cross-up button that hit both sides. It's a very, very good way to deal with just jumping around. Alright. I'm gonna go for the big combo. I'm gonna bait him into doing the counter again. I didn't need to do the homing cancel, but I'm too used to it. Oh, that was a pretty high damage combo. I tried to reflect it last second. But 5B, not fast enough. Again, not what I wanted. Every time I do 5C, I never mean to do it. It just kind of happens. I think what I'm trying to do when I get 5C like that is just up back homing. But up back sometimes puts you in pre-block if there's a move out on the screen. So you kind of get glued to the ground and you don't get the jump for the homing. So instead, you just get stancy and it's like, oh, alright. Guess I'm doing an overhead. Most of the time it works though, because it comes out really randomly. Times when you wouldn't usually use it. Ow, like that too. You better believe I'm gonna cash out on his damage, is what I would say. Ah, I missed it. Ah. So in that situation from now on, I should probably just do a normal combo. This might kill. Yeah, this will definitely kill. When you see there, this part starting to fill up, and you have that much meter, there's no reason not to be super in that situation. Let's kill him fast. Oh, here's a command grab. Every single time, I'm like, oh, here's a command grab. I don't know why I'm taking this. Oh no. I could have killed the super. Alright, that's not where you want to push block. For sure. 99% of the time, if I do a charge 5B and it's blocked, I'm always gonna do a 236B afterwards. Because if people block that, they almost always push block it. And I almost always hit them with the punch right afterwards. Where am I? What's happening? Help! Why am I on that side of the screen? Oh, I pressed 5B. 5B is not a great anti-air. As you might imagine. I like combo. And jump BB from his armor? Seems like a really good button. I try to clash it with the 5B, but I'll take this. I'd much rather have Heart as an anchor. Oh, you're gonna let me live. I don't know if you heard me mash that DP, but I was mashing that DP. That punch is really bad on whiff. And really easy to bait. Cause he just made it whiff. But he's not really doing it. That means Sandy's won, so whatever. Every balloon's working for him. Alright, how long have I been going? A little bit too long, I would say. So I think after this game, I'm gonna call last, wind it down for the night, and that'll be it. I try to do the oh, then you need to clash the burst there. He might be dead. Nah, it's gonna hurt. Oh no, he slashed it. Oh, that's gonna hurt. Let me not touch the height button. Let me not touch that height button until she gets the green life back. Sometimes you really gotta show restraint when you get happy birthday. Your assist takes a lot of damage. I'm gonna call the last one. You gotta have the restraint to not push the assist button sometimes. But it's hard. Not pushing that button is really hard sometimes. Ooh, the Labyrinth theme on the last game. Ooh, I like this. Calling an assist, doing neutral, homing up forward. Really good option. He's gonna do that. Empty homing in their face, homing down to the ground. I wake up against a counter. I have no idea what I could have done there. Let's go. That's the best I can get. Oh no, the trade. Yeah, I'm not gonna let him dash in my face like that. I know it was pressure goals. I've been respecting it so far. This is the last game. I know his habits. I know what he likes to do in boxing. Oh, which reminds me. It's not a bad idea to just sit there and block sometimes. With how often people push block, not everyone has great offense. They expect you to push block. So, if you just sit there and see what they like to do for their offensive pressure, it can really benefit you. Maybe give you an insight into their habits. Oh, okay. Ooh, I think I can combo off that. Out of there, I guess. Alright. Oh, there was a backhoeing, but I kind of got crossed up in the middle of the move and I didn't know which way to do that. Oh, okay, that's why he does that. I've been wondering why he does that EX move and then whiffs it, then does another one. I guess that's why. Now I rarely go for the toss up in the corner. Uh oh. Uh oh. That's not good. Now he doesn't have meter to deal with this, and this is gonna do a lot of chip. And it's hard to avoid these fireballs. Uh oh, I might be dead. Yeah, got him. Yeah. Hearts, stand AA, pulls you out of the corner for a little bit. So you can go for a cross-up pretty easy after that. Get ready. Especially if they don't push block. If they are going to push block and stuff, it's a little more difficult to try and go for that. But if they respect your pressure enough to not push block, it's a very strong tool to have in your arsenal. Not a good start for him. Okay, so I should mention that setup is a safe jump, but only if you actually block. And oftentimes, I'm not blocking, I feel like. It's not gonna give me too much, but messed up. Gotta miss input again. Cross up my inputs. Got a fireball. Oh, it actually hit. Wow. Hit really low. Alright, that's it for me. Going out on a loss. Going to bed sad because I'm going out on a loss. But I'd say overall, I got a lot of wins. So I'm gonna say GG. Going to bed. So let's recap what I learned today. What did I learn? Good question. I learned that Akatsuki jump loop is pretty hard to do. I learned that I should experiment more with cross up EX dive kick plus an assist. Because I did that on accident a few times, more than a few times, and it hit pretty much every single time. It looks really, really good, but I haven't been using it. So maybe that's something I should practice and develop. I can't really think of much else, offhand at least. But it's good to have at least one thing after a nice long session like this that you want to focus on. And I think developing that EX dive kick plus an assist setup is going to be what I'm going to focus on here. So thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed this. But that's it for me. Thank you for watching. And stay tuned for more.